I hope this works. I don't know why. Is it on? Okay, 7, 8, 9. Is it on? Stop recording. No, start recording. Hi. Happy holidays, one and all.
Hello, everybody.
Hi, everyone trying to get close in.
I'm in.
Please. Hi, it is Miss Troy's AriesFire. I had a few guests. Happy holidays to everyone when I do put this on Facebook. I hope this is in sync.
It looks like it.
I hope so. I haven't done this in a while, and it's like, I forgot what I'm supposed to be doing here, but I believe that I have everything right because it says to start recording. Yes, I'm here with
Likewater,
Beverly Likewater Jackson.
Hi,
we have Miss Pat Tamborine here.
Hello.
We have Mr. James Lightsly here.
Yo.
We have the fabulous Ahmani Love here. And we have Steven, who just stepped away from the camera for a moment. He'll be back. Polo was here. And my nephew, Lancey, he is still on his way.
Okay, great,
Lancey. Yeah. So anyway, I invited my friends over for just a little bit of snacks, and we exchanged some gifts. And some stuffy stuff. Always with the stuffy stuff. Cheers. Guess what we're drinking? We went back totally old school. We're drinking cherry kiafa. I'm telling you, this stuff is so delicious. I've not had this in, I can't tell you how long.
Yes.
It's been that long that I can't tell you how long.
It's a very good drink, still, people. Check it out.
Yes, it's very, very much old school. And I invited them over to have a good time. Look, there's Steven.
Ahmani is over on the couch. Y'all can't see her.
There's Ahmani. See, she's all Christmas out. That's so cute. So, I just wanted to come back on the camera. Househeadz at home. We're still here.
Really quickly. Yes.
And I know we had promised in the past that so we're going to come back on and do some cereal kind of segments for the fall, spring, winter season and all that. But once again, hey, life gets in the way. And hey, I didn't make the time for it. So I'm making the time for it now.
Real quickly.
Yes, right. Turn on these cameras and let everyone say hey. Hey, we're in. I'm in for the night. Tonight there's what? 11's at the cricket club.
Just parties here and
yeah,
there.
Yeah, parties all around here, there, and everywhere.
And we just couldn't make it out. So we just said, let's get together and go for a walk in the park.
Da-da-da-da.
And while we're walking, we'll do a little kiss in the dark. I wanna walk with you.
See you, Matt.
I wanna talk with you, but it's up to you to say, come on, baby, if you don't hurry up. I go crazy cause I walk in the park all alone. It's just no fun.
No fun.
What you can easily do.
Sing.
It's so hard to be done by one. Okay, that's it. We just let
you
know. I don't own the rights.
No, she doesn't own the rights.
That was my voice, not the record.
That's
so,
right.
Yeah, I do own
totally
the rights.
Totally naturally a cappella. Right,
yeah.
That's right. From her mouth to your ears, straight.
I know that you can.
Who made that song?
Mary Wells.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah,
okay.
That was a song that Mary Wells made before she went to London.
Okay.
She made two lovers, and I ain't ashamed. Yeah, let me tell you about my
lovers.
Yeah, she was cool. She went to London, and she went out there, and she lived out there for the rest until she passed away.
Oh, wow. Interesting.
Yeah, but Mary Wells is a great singer.
Likewater, as always, is a wealth of knowledge and energy. I need to try to get everybody in this camera here.
Yeah, we got it.
You see what I'm working with, right?
Satellite search for black people.
I'm trying to.
Yay.
I don't know. Anyway.
Yeah, but that was a favorite song.
I better get this right instead of messing with it. Go get it back again. Before I lose it. That's a little better. James Lightsly, you want to come up a little closer to the camera? So, since this is just about the end of the year for everyone, how was your year? How was your year in-house? To your parties, your experiences, you know, did you have a good time? Did you hear any good music?
And, you know, I think I had a good time. I was in outdoor parties. I think outdoor functions was very exciting this week.
Okay.
Yeah, me too.
This summer month, I think that everybody was on their A-game when they was doing their house functions. We had a few maybe technical difficulties, but I think that everything went as according to plan in summer. Every house event, I think the weather was at its peak.
Yeah,
we got blessed with very good weather.
We didn't have too many rain outs. It didn't even rain all the way out at the white party. The white party,
we went to the white party.
But that was very refreshing.
That was very refreshing.
Beautiful.
That was beautiful.
For those who's never got a chance to dance in the rain,
that was the leaves was falling down. We were dancing in the rain.
Yeah, for sure.
The thunder was coming down.
Yes.
The sky was crying. All right, people, you get two songs now. That's another song. Y'all got another song now.
So, you said, Stephen, you had a good time with the outdoor parties and the weather and all that. Everything was put together really well. I did, too. I actually went to almost all of them that were over here in Jersey. I was glad because the weather did cooperate. Yeah. It wasn't so awfully hot. It was nice. Everything was... It was good. I enjoyed the summer.
Yeah, so I'm going to say the same thing because me and Pookie did good this summer. We had some nice outdoor events.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right on, the water movement.
Yes.
So, but not publicizing tonight because it ain't a business thing. But going out to different parties, I had a ball this summer. And hopefully next summer I can make it to more events, do some beachy stuff, and actually touch the water, like get to the water on the island.
Nice. Yeah.
Because we never get the chance to go into the water. Not saying I want to go in.
Well, you got to get there real early.
Yeah, because we be too busy enjoying the boardwalk. But I had a beautiful summer, Curly. All your experiences we went through with you this summer, Curly, going through your operation.
Yep, God bless you. Yep.
God bless y'all.
Yes, both of them.
Yep. Earth.
Hanging strong,
and
too.
All of the, everything going
continue
through.
Blessings. Continue
beautiful
blessings.
Summer. Me and Stephen and Troy hung out heavy this year with Pat.
Yes,
Ahmani,
yes, yes.
All of our,
that's why I wanted to celebrate
these are the
them.
Hanging people. Yes.
And
people.
I want to give a shout out to Stephen Grill that he bought.
His portable grill.
I want to give a shout out to Steven's magic grill that he will be following along as we are out in the parks doing our little
really? What? It was the cutest thing.
Yes.
It really traveled well. I was quite impressed. Like, look at this.
Yeah.
But it's our little kitty carry-all.
That was cute.
That was very cute.
That will
quite compact. And it did the trick, and it cooked really well, too.
It cooked everything.
It cooked everything crispy good, like an air fryer. It was very good for us.
It was nicely compact. It was just enough to grill.
And it carried well. It did.
Very bachelor.
You know what I got on? I must say, I want to show this off.
I got propane bottles, no, half the size of that wine bottle.
I'm wearing a kimono top that was given to me by Lauren. Lauren Hatcher. Yes, I love Lauren. And this is my first time wearing it. He gave it to me at Fort Greene, the first Fort Greene last year. And I'm so appreciative. This is when he was in Japan. And he had just got off from climbing one of these high mountains. He did tell me the mountain, but I don't remember it. If I heard it, I would recognize it. And he got down, he climbed down off that mountaintop. And it was like a souvenir store there, I guess you could call it. And yes, he saw this beautiful photo, and he said he immediately thought
that's
of me.
That's nice.
He immediately thought of me. And he brought this all the way from Japan and had it all wrapped up and found me in the park and gave it to me.
Wow.
And yes, I feel special. Yes, indeed, I do. So thank you, Lauren. I have it on at my little holiday get together, so our way of sorts.
Yes. People of the world.
Yes, Ahmani, would you like to describe your summertime experience into the fall, winter season of house?
She said she's chilling. Well, you do have to get on
the camera. Come on, girl. Get over here. It's your pretty face.
Hold it.
They didn't see that.
Oh, my God. Mine is just quick and simple and to the point. It was all love and peace for me. I love y'all. My whole neck was cracking.
Yes, the Bohemian child has spoken.
No problems, because I'm all love. I radiate love, or I keep some love, baby.
She does. True. That's why she's here. Yes. Well said. Well said. Yes. Everywhere she goes, she just vibes and grooves and just, yes.
Floated like a
cat. Yes, she does. Bohemian style. That's her. James, did you have a good time this summer?
Not bad. I mean, got around to a couple of,
events.
Mostly work.
Yeah. But you did make some of them there. Yeah, so, they get better with age as anything. So now we're here in the fall winter season. And all the parties, once again, all crammed into the same weekends, virtually the same weekends. And they're all crammed right down the street, across the street from one another. Wow, you know what? You have to stop doing that. You really need to dig yourself. So that's just really not nice, is it?
Takes a toll.
The competition and all that. We're like the only nationality that do that between each other. You shouldn't do that. You know, everyone, pretty soon no one's going to be dancing at all. They'll have the cameras out, only taking pictures and recording, and just like they do over in Europe. And that's what this is going to turn into. And there's too many people out there. This is just my opinion. I'm not saying, I don't care if you agree with me or not. I don't care. This is just the way that I feel. It's just too much of that. Here you go, we're the party here, and then you go find some other spot directly across the street. That's just, wow. You know, I want us all to succeed. I would like that. But wow, you know, you all really need to dig yourselves. Just all really need to dig yourselves. Well, I have been wanting, that's how I feel. I've been wanting to say that. And so I said that. It's just too much competition. It's just, with the parties. Every time we turn around, there's just, everything's all congested and everybody's after the same crowd.
There's not a lot of us.
And there's not a lot of us. You know? It's just not. But I hope one day, hey, we all get it together, blah, blah, blah. Whatever. Until then, you just try to pick and choose. You know what? This is a thought. Listen to this. Here's a thought. If you're going to do a party, right, and you're within the same vicinity, why don't you do, you pay one price and you can get in with the other party, or vice versa. There should be some other incentive. Why should I can't pay over here and across the street or pay again this way. So you maybe
like
should work some
like
out. There you go. And then we're all transferred back and forth. That's right. Like a bus. Excellent idea. That's the excellent thing to call it. You can do transfers back and forth to the party that way. Just like on a Flintstones.
They should do
I saw that on
the
Flintstones. You can just transfer in and out of the parties, and everybody's parties will be maintained with dances. And everyone else, why don't you do that? Because I personally, I feel bad if I can't go to this person's party. You got your party same day. It's right there, man. I don't like to be told like that. I want to go. I'm just like, oh, wow, such and such is playing over here. And, oh, such and such is playing over here, too. Wow. So why don't you do that? If you're going to put a party on the same date, I suggest you do a transfer of sorts, okay? Because if you don't pay to get into one party, that money that you save, you can use it at the bar.
So, like,
okay? And I'm sure people will say, hey, well, you can't afford to go out, stay home, I'll drink.
You know,
that's not, that's going to end up closing everything down, shutting everything down.
And it's just one kind of conversation, and I haven't even
tackled this shit, but I've never actually done it. So let me turn around, turn my attention to what the other folks are talking about in the back.
This machine has played a dark cloud to disrupt our independent thought patterns. We wonder, where is everyone? I want to be there. I have to be seen. You know, I want to know what
yes, James.
I want to follow the followers that follow the followers following the followers that follow the followers.
Ah, yeah. Send this
hot. Suckers following the followers like a bunch of robotic, you know, zombies. Yeah, so that's how my whole take of that whole
followers.
Yo, I mean,
yeah, I'm on it too. I can dig it because
you're talking to the camera, please.
Oh, sorry. Being independent. When you're an independent thinker or you're independently raised, while your parent give you independency, not saying that they're making you, they're not caring about you. When you're an independent thinker, that means you can think for yourself. You're not a follower. And that means that you can go where you want without somebody saying, well, I thought you was going to go here.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
I thought you was going to go there. Mm-hmm. So how you thinking for me when you're not a follower? If you're thinking for me, you tell me where you thought I was going to go.
Mm.
Don't think for me.
Right. How about that?
That's the first thing a person gets offended when you say that. And they say, I'm not thinking for you. But if I'm independent, yes, you are. You telling me where you thought I was going to be. That's thinking for me. So that's why I don't try to be at every party. So when people say, I thought you was going to be at such and such party. How you thinking for me when I live in East Orange and you live in Brooklyn?
Wait, is that serious? I mean, yes, people will really get offended if you don't.
What I don't appreciate is if someone put online, I know I'm expecting you to be there. Don't do that.
It's simple. The bottom line is, on some for real shit, it's boring supporting the same fucking people over and over and over again. And chances are they'll never support you back.
That's true.
You understand? You know, so it gets boring, you know. I'm not beat to show up at everybody's fucking place. And for the most part, these big name DJs say whack as hell. Most of them sound whack as hell. I mean, let's just be
fucking
just sound fucking corny. I mean, if I had my eyes closed, I couldn't tell who the fuck was playing because after a while, everybody sounded like.
Yeah.
Just saying.
That's
how you really feel.
That's why I keep you awake at night, right? Because this one just me personally, my perspective, you know.
You're spending money to
my perspective.
Sometimes,
you know, hey, no house event should be more than $10. Period. Because it's too. It's like it's everywhere. It's too available.
Mm-hmm.
You can get house music on the internet for free 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Right.
You're not doing anything. What is the music going to do? Give me pulling properties and shit, you know. you know what I mean? You know,
how about that?
I mean, bless me with $1 million and that's fucking the music just sounds the same. It's the same. You're all playing the same shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're not doing anything magical with it. It's nothing exciting you're doing with the fucking music, with the song. It's nothing. It all sounds the same.
Mm-hmm.
You close your eyes, I can tell who the fuck
who's
is playing.
Trying, right.
Really? Yeah. That's right. I mean,
but you're all biting on a fucking name.
Yeah.
I think nowadays they don't emphasize on structure, like club structure anymore.
Mm-hmm.
I think they just, as long as they can get a room or a hall and throw up some speakers, they really consider that as a party.
Yeah.
Yeah, how about that?
Now, to me, I think a real part is when someone went through their best in the fucking space. Mm-hmm. Like Zanzibar, like Paradise Garage, like Better Days, mm-hmm. like, you know,
yeah,
like just like clubs. Aries, like
yeah.
clubs, like in the back of the cave.
It was give and take.
And
but
they
these parties are taking. You're not getting shit for your money.
That's
you don't get
that
music shit because you got music as whack as hell.
But the point is, that
plastic cups at the bar for your big drink.
Like you said, the party, the theme.
Yeah, the
of
thing.
It's part.
Hors d'oeuvres going about what? Something. Make me feel like you appreciate my
brand. That's right.
Yeah, they don't appreciate instead of trying to suck your pockets dry.
The pink party, garages had a pink party, everything, pink champagne, pink party, that was a nice party. To be fair, there are some parties.
There are some parties that do give you something when you do go. You do feel special. There are some hostesses that are like that.
Okay, now let's talk the positive side of this. Okay, now just talk positive about these parties. Now, what parties do you think are really that give you a bang for the buck?
Oh, I'm about to say. One who I do enjoy to go to, my friend Likewater, of course.
Thank you.
Yes, and not just because she's my friend. Even if I didn't know her, I like her banter at the door. She's very earthy. She's very easy to talk to. And she's very inviting and funny. And she's witty and all of that at the door. And she's nice to everyone as long as you're nice to her, naturally, okay? Yeah, she's very personable. And number two, I like Charmaine's parties.
Yeah.
I've always said that. I like Charmaine. She's such
that
a consummate.
Same
yeah, the same color party. Yeah. She's such a good hostess. She comes around. She has the,
snacks
and hors d'oeuvres and jello shots and all of that. And those who want to partake do. And those who don't, you know, you're still offered. And she's pleasant. She, again, too, is pleasant to everyone. Okay? Everyone. She's very welcoming, whether it's outdoor parties or her indoor parties. And I really look forward to going to her parties because I like the DJs that the guest DJs that play there too. And I like Charmaine's parties. I like the girls when she has Adia Eshmont and Montana. I like that one too. And
you used to play at Jefferson Street. Over there at the club on Jefferson Street, at the Black Box too, right?
And that guy named Stim. They'll give Stim his
club. Well, now they're talking about individual DJs. Yeah.
Oh, I know.
But when
no
you
names,
asked the question,
I
was answering. Yes, she didn't. Yeah, you have to stay on subject. I'm trying to.
Trying to stay on subject.
Yeah. Yeah. To answer Ahmani's question, right on the positive side, what parties did you like going to? Right? That's what you asked. So I said I like Likewater's parties, like Social Butterfly, the New Beginning parties, because she's such a good hostess and all. And I like the guest DJs and all. And number two, I like Charmaine. I like the Sankofa party. Charmaine is such a good hostess, and the people that she surrounds herself with too.
Yeah.
They're nice to everyone. That's very important because I've said this before in the past. I've been to parties where if, you know, whoever is hosting, whether it's one or two or whatever, if they, you know, they're not so hot on you or who or whatever, then, you know, they give you stank face the whole night sort of a thing.
Yeah, like me,
yeah, exactly. Me, mother, you. And I'm like, really? Really, you,
like
your nasty attitude should not be at the freaking door. You shouldn't be at the door.
I don't get any of that.
Never have. They're nice and pleasant as well. You're hosting the party.
Not like you sitting over there.
So if you think that you can't do that, you're not capable of that, and you have, you know, secret animosities against people, then you shouldn't do that. Or what I do, I don't go to those parties. Are you fucking kidding me? And I answered it too.
Is it really that serious?
Well,
it can be. If you only got 90 people, and you're trying to stretch those 90 people to six places in one night, you been promoting your ass off on 10.
You can only go. What's your favorite party?
Do you just go?
I like to go to them all. You know.
As long as you got wood, as long as you got wooden floors, concrete is bad on our old knees.
You got a good wooden floor. You're not charging crazy at charging price. You got top notch DJs. Since it's all about the music, and for me, in the end, that's really it. I like to be greeted nicely, whatever. Find my spot on the floor, on the dance floor, and commence dancing, which is what I came to do.
I enjoy my own space.
Yeah.
Woo! That's me.
Yeah.
That's me too.
To myself and for 2020, I'll just, in order for me, I want to go out and really dance and enjoy that. I don't want to go when it's a lot of that double indemnity stuff going on, you know. I don't want to do that again because the crowd just gets totally out of hand. And they're just not, a lot of them, you know, as everything is mixed, it's the outdoorsies. Now they found their way into where we are, and they have absolutely no etiquette. Okay, yeah, I said it. You pop, you're drunk, visibly drunking, and you're plowing all through the crowd. You don't fuck if you down there or not. I've arrived. Now you hitting, kicking, kung fu fight. Don't do that. Okay, I don't like that shit. Because I don't do that, okay? And I don't want nobody trying to bring out... I don't want to lose my religion out there on the fucking dance floor. That's bottom fucking line. So I don't want to fraternize in that, so I will just pull myself away from that. And I won't attend, and it's cool because there's so many other places. I'd rather party in New York. That's where I always was. But then, if I can't get there, and you know, hey, Jihad is good, I like to rock the Jihad. But then all that other stuff that follows now, like, I don't want to be in that. That's
well,
what
Ahmani
I said.
Made a statement. She said, bang the drums is for us.
Uh-huh.
And the other party is for the R&B crowd.
Yeah, totally.
Are you quoting me right?
No, because you made sense. Because I got it when you said it.
Likewater wants to feel strict.
When you said it, no, I got it. When you said it, you made sense.
Well, we're talking.
I said exactly what you said.
We're going to take a quick station break, but they're going to keep talking. Yeah, we're going to refill our cocktail glass.
Like the dancers,
be right back.
I feel like that's the thing. That's
us.
Did
you
care
about that? And it was the name of another party that you said that he do. And I got it when you said it, because to hear how the R&B party, what you said, yeah, to bang the drum, that's for us. And you made sense when you said that. It registered. I said, okay, he's telling the truth. You made sense.
Because
he does. Yeah, and I don't know. That's what I'm trying to get to with that other. That's what I'm trying to go to. What that other.
The music that you know.
Yes.
You know that we know about.
So I was referring.
Oh, shit, I ain't hear that.
Yes. So I was referring when you said that other shit, like you just said.
Christmas gift baskets. Look at mine. I got James bought 6 packs. And since we already drank this cake, I want to be okay to share. Well, not only here, but here. So, guys, I'm going to have a nice smart one. See, my guests are having lovely parties.
Thank you.
Yeah, okay. Excuse us, people.
Yes, you're just making cocktails. Whatever. Please continue.
I don't know. She was going to.
Oh, you still got the thing right?
Okay, just talking about
it. Well,
interesting stories about yourself.
Name of the moment. Yeah, I think that was my book shelter. The original?
The original.
Hubert Street Experience. I think that Hubert Street Experience.
Yeah, the Hubert Street Experience was like unlike any other.
Yeah.
I mean, I was living in Brooklyn at the time, and I can remember getting up like 12 o'clock midnight, leaving out of my house 2 in the morning and going, you know, just jumping on an 8 train, you know, going to the shelter. It's strange, you know, because I was like familiar with all of them from like the 80s, you know. That was like our life force, you said. Radio was everything back then, you know what I mean? And so that's how I started following their parties, you know, even before they had the shelter party. They were doing parties as they were like right out the Palladium. We all used to like go parties there, you know, some people spend there, you know. But the Hubert Street was the best experience to me.
And sidebar, I would do the Afterlife party and I would do the Wild Pitch party. When you went up in there, you thought you was back in the prehistoric Fred Flintstone on planet Mars with the spaceship hanging all up in the ceiling.
You know, that's what I was talking about when it came to clubs, being
They had Saturn, the moon, and they get from one end.
And the DJ booth was a big ass Crisco can, and it looked just like a Crisco can too.
Wow.
It wasn't a cheap ass Crisco can, it was a Crisco can. I was like, wow.
Wow.
It was a little good day spot.
Yeah, and yeah. That whole energy.
And then you know what? When you went to go on the other side, they actually had like one of those wooden little rickety little bridge things that you actually had to walk over, like you was actually on a planet Mars. They had pinball machines and everything up in that thing. Wow, that was beautiful.
You want to play that back for you, too. You want to play that back for you, too.
Yes, you see, this is what happens for real at Househeadz at Home. I'm telling you, Househeadz at Home is real. It's the real deal. It's not scripted. We're real people, and it's 35 minutes. This is really fun. I hope if you don't watch the whole thing, you watch it and come back to it. That's my nephew, Will Delancey, coming up. Is he in?
Yep, he's here.
Hey, boy. Come say hello.
Hey, everybody.
Oh, look at you. Look at Ahmani. Hey,
everybody. Look.
Oh, it's so cute. I love that.
I always get that sweater from Mark.
Oh, shit. Just take a picture.
Oh, my God.
I got to get you on the Ahmani. You got to stand up.
My nephew and Ahmani have similar hookups. That's so cool. That's so cute. Yeah, get your phone back, please. Happy holidays to everyone. Only one missing is my daughter, my lovely daughter, Asia. She's getting ready to go away. She'll be leaving Christmas, going to Anguilla. Again, yeah, so she won't be here for the holidays. She'll be on her own holiday. And yay for her. That's the way I live. That's what I have done in the past. So, hey, she's just following her mother's footsteps.
Oh, hey, Merry Christmas, we out here.
Wish you tidings and good cheer. Yes.
Love a new beginning.
Yes. And think about what I said in the coming parties, the future of the parties. just try not to backbite each other, okay? And maybe you should just do bigger parties incorporated together. How about that? Then everybody could. Yeah, like it used to be, where everybody went to everybody's party.
We'll fix something out.
Yeah, that's what my hope is.
I love a song. Yeah.
Yes. Oh, he needs
love, peace, and hand grease for the afro, yo.
Yes. Yes. And always remember to dance strong. When you dance strong, yeah, you put all your heart in it. And dance strong. Yes. When you feel like you're at the end of your rope, I'm going to sign off with my favorite sign off. You tie a knot in it, baby, and you dance. Dance strong. Later. Ending it up where you go.